your sofa.
Lalu Prasad has been posting a series of photographs of primary health centers in Sitamarhi, Sekhpura, Kaimur and Madhubani to name a few, aligning their neglect during CM Nitish Kumar tenure and has turned their either to buffalo shelter or unstable log properties. Rashtriya Janata Dal United Chief Lalu Prasad Yadav has made his presence in Bihar politics felt with continuous attack on Chief Minister Nitish Kumar's handling of the COVID-19 pandemic and the poor state of healthcare system. Since his release on bail is fooder scam cases in April this year, on Tuesday Prasad posted pictures of one dilapidated building aligning into the referral hospital in Saharsa district, which he claimed what is the symbols like thousands of other primary health centers in state. The referral hospital in Saharsa, built at cost of 14 crores, was inaugurated by me as Chief Minister in 1995 to provide health care to lakhs of people living on the both side of East and West Kosi. But it was ruined like thousands of other primary health care by one person who is narrow and negative minded. Harish Khan was arrested on Tuesday after the NCB team, led by his journal director Sameer Wankhede, conducted raids at various local and suburban Andheri, Lokhandwala and Bandra. The NCB said Narcotics Control Bureau has arrested drug peddler Harish Khan over his allied links with gangster and drug peddler Parvez Khan, alias Chinku Pathan, and associated with fugitive underworld don Daud Ibrahim. An NCB official said on Wednesday, the NCB will also conduct an investigation to Khan's role in drug case linked to Bollywood actor Sushant Singh Rajput's death last year. Bihar Social Welfare Department used to give ₹1,000 to the families of maintenance of children under the foster care. Now, Chief Minister Nitish Kumar has announced ₹1,500 for children under foster care. Bihar government's Parvarish scheme meant to secure foster care and home for across children orphaned by COVID-19 pandemic is showing promising result, with several parents coming forward and a family in Muzaffarpur being handed over the first such child. Gonda Police Chief Santosh Kumar Mishra said the blast occurred at Tateka Purva locality where Wazir Ganj Police Station limits at around 11 p.m. on Tuesday. Seven persons, including three children aged between 5 and 12 years, were killed, while seven others were seriously injured in the double-story building collapse triggered by the mysterious blast in the Uttar Pradesh Gonda district late on Tuesday night, senior police officials said on Wednesday. Initial police investigation suggested the building collapsed after a LPG gas cylinder exploded in the house, but further probe in the ascertained exact cause. Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath expressed his grief over the deaths and directed officials to ensure best possible treatment for the injured and help the family of the deceased. In a video sent to BJP workers, Rinkal Khera's brother Mani accused Sunny alike that the police have spared Councillor Gurdeep Singh Netu due to his political connections, wanted by Ludhiana police in 3-year-old murder of Bharatiya Janata Party supporter Jagdeep Singh alias Rinkal Khera, proclaimed offered Sunny Nair appeared on social networking sites with a confession video and claimed that he executed the killing at behest of Congress Councillor Gurdeep Singh Netu and his two sons. The charge was rubbished by Nita, who said that the special investigation team had already given him a clean sheet. In a video sent to Rinkal's brother Mani, Sunny alleged that the police has spared Netu due to the political connections. Sunny said he is ready to become a witness in the case. Mani said he will meet Director General of the Police Dinkar Gupta and Ludhiana Police Commissioner Rakesh Agarwal and demand arrest of Netu.
That's all for today. For further updates, stay tuned with News 19.